Hi guys, it's Ernst from EDH Construction again. As I mentioned in the previous video, I'm just going to run over of exactly what we do when we prep a roof, especially one that's been painted before, as well as the rusted roofs. We use very similar things. Firstly, we will go around with what you guys call a putty knife or a scraper or whatever the case might be. We chip off as much dead paint as we can. What we don't get off with this, we move to chicken mesh. We bunch it up and you get something like this. And this scratches that old paint off quite well. Then whatever you can't get off with these two methods, we go to sandpaper or to steel brush, depending on the surface. And we just leave a key on what is left, because obviously what's left doesn't want to come off. You will leave a key on this for the paint to stick to. That's getting it to an almost ready state. If there's something really bad, we also go in with, for example, these Superflex flappy discs. We use old ones. The new ones are a bit too abrasive for your corrugated iron. So I tend to use the ones that are after we build vertical guards or something like that. You get the ones that's not so abrasive anymore. We use that to just get off the worst paint, rusts and so forth, and paints as well. And then from there, we will just sand and use steel brushes to get that stuff off. After we've got the roof relatively clean, we go around and check for damaged screws or damaged boards, corrugated iron plates and so forth. This is the old type of, normal type of roof screws or roof nails that we get in South Africa. It's got like a helical type of thread on it with a plastic washer with a zinc top. It often happens that they work their way out with vibration of the wing. Sometimes they rust off, sometimes the wood expands because the water got in there. And they don't hold the corrugated iron properly anymore. What we do is we get these kind of screws. They've got a hex head and quite a coarse thread. And we use bonded EVA washers. It's like a EVA foam that is stuck to this. It's bonded. So it'll never let go of that. So once you've got that combination and you pull that flush, it seals that and it won't come off again. Now, obviously there's a length difference. We do use the longer ones where we take the longer screws out, where the shorter ones are. Sometimes I still use the longer ones, just so that they can tap into a little bit of new wood and hold them secure. You get the same type of screw that's already got a little drill bit for metal purlins. And also what we do is, if we find damaged plates or that's slightly bent and they open up a little bit, what we do is we put a couple of pop rivets in, or blind rivets, whatever you guys call it. That just holds the corrugator together again to make a nice weather seal. Where this doesn't work, we normally have two products, or three. This is called a fiber cut. This has got a built-in fibers in the paint. It's a waterproofer, but you get the same product from the same guys that is just a waterproofing paint. Then you would use membrane with it. And we seal old screw caps, everywhere with these little holes or previous holes from damage from screws and so forth, that does it where there's no more place to fix it. Or if you found a screw that is still holding nicely, but there's a little bit of a gap next to it, we seal it with this. If it's not a big hole, I like to use this. It's a South African product once again, PCT Aquaflex. You don't need membrane with it. There's no fibers in it. It's UV stable, environmentally friendly. It's got a whole list of awesome things that it can do. This stuff becomes like a rubber. It's a really great product to seal roofs with. I've done a lot with this as well. Then after the roof has now been sanded, it's been prepped for paint. So now the only thing that's left is two stages. The first thing is what we do is we use a high industrial high pressure washer to get all that sand, grit and muck off the roof, bird droppings, dust. You will be surprised how much dust is on a roof. As well as the stuff that we just sanded off, the bad stuff. We wash it off with a pressure washer, normally with about a 25 degree angle. It blasts quite nicely and we get rid of it. We also at the same time clean the gutters. So you get rid of all the old screws and debris that was on the roof. We clean that out and dispose of that as well. Then we go over to, shall I say, the third thing that was a big topic on the previous video was the paint itself. I use a drill with this attachment to stir the paint, so that way I know I've got the best mixed paint that I can possibly do on a site without a vibrating shaker or something like that. This is what we will use, and it works quite well. Then we move on to the actual paint. The paint that I was talking about is Renoff ACP28. It's a South African product. I've spoken to the guys. It might be available soon in the US. So all thumbs for you guys. It's ACP28. It's an anti-corrosive paint. It's a primer and a top coat all in one. I do apply two coats, liberal coats, to a roof. You can paint it directly onto steel. You need to leave 6 to 8 hours drying time between coats, as the ACP reacts, like I said in the previous video, reacts with the rust, converts it, and it leaves a little white. It's almost like a little residue, but it's actually not loose, so you can paint straight over that. I do, however, because you've waited 8 hours, there's wind, sometimes rain in between, that kind of thing, we do wash the roof again just to get loose stuff off. Birds do come and sit on the roof. And so you've got a clean surface on top of that, and we clean that off. I'll add another picture of a first coat application that we've done with this Renoff product. And with one coat, you can't brush it off with a steel brush. It really cleans to surfaces really well. This product is really, I've been working with it for about 4 years, and I haven't had any issues, comebacks or anything with it. It's really a great product, and it saves a lot of time because you don't have to go and spot treat rust. You don't have to get a base coat on and then get two coats of top coat on. So it saves you time, saves you money, and the product lasts. I'll vouch for that. So you've got your primer, top coat, it's all in one. Two coats of this and you're sorted. Thanks.